So today I thought we'd talk about the vault. So the vault is a part of the agency. The agency is my business. And in my business, generally people will hire me and then I will fly to them and we'll do a 3-day brainstorming and filming session. And then I create advertisements, landing pages, websites, and tons of promo material out of that, sales funnels. But that can run people up to $25,000, because we're reinventing the wheel each time. So I'd come up with this concept a while back, but kind of didn't put it into fruition until like a year and a half ago. And I call it the Vault. I first called it the Innovation Lab. And now I call it the Vault, and I relaunched it. Now, when I told Mallory about it, she said that's like on Clueless. Now, I know that seems kind of funny, but in my business, sometimes I will digitally alter my clothing to match whatever look I need because I don't either have the time or the budget to get the look I'm going for. And if it's going to be an image, why not? Just like this background is obviously green screen. There's not an actual vault there. So what I'd come up with is since my clients on the high end, sure, they can afford a $25,000 advertising package, but I didn't want to leave out every other person that I could service. And so what I thought of is a $3,000 package. Well, $3,000 for image ads and $5,000 for video ads. And what I do is every time that I create an ad for myself or my clients, I will then put it inside the vault. And then every person in the vault can then say, "Hey, I'd like that same thing." And so they can essentially order it up on a menu instead of having me reinvent the wheel. It makes it a lot easier. And also they're getting better work than they would anywhere else. And so I also saw this article from a woman who runs a business for high-end entrepreneurs or just rich people. And she calls it the vault.
Today, the tradition of having your own personal valets and stylists is as sophisticated as your technology. Welcome to Vault Couture, the finest solution in wardrobe management worldwide. Experience our four pillars of service: sort, style, send, and store your couture garments and accessories. Each piece from your collection will be professionally photographed and uploaded to your virtual vault. Then you can access your wardrobe pieces online in exquisite high definition or call upon our professional staff straight from your web-connected device. Sort your pieces by look, by travel destination, or by event. Style yourself virtually or hire a Vault Couture stylist through the app. Create looks so you're ready for your next event and keep track of what you've already worn. Order custom alterations straight from the app. Send your styled looks between residences or to global travel destinations using Vault Couture's well-controlled packing and shipping services. Store your vintage couture and investment pieces in our climate-controlled secure vaults. Our archival technique will ensure your fashion pieces live on as heirlooms. Join a circle of discerning international clientele who have entrusted their cultivated wardrobes to Vault Couture. For more information, visit vaultcouture.com.
So I love that. And so what I have going essentially works the same. For instance, take what I did the other day.
So this is a shot I'm looking to do that I like that Tom Cruise did for Mission Impossible Rogue Nation. So he essentially does this. So it was roughly in focus. I just wasn't in the shot all the way. So hopefully I will be now. And then I just need to put my hair up. And I want it to kind of be uniform around here. And so what I'll do is I'll just grab the remote and I'll put it in my hand. And then I'll start clicking. And you'll see the results in just a moment. Photo. So I'll essentially put some sort of grunge elements behind me and also in front of me on my coat and around here and on my face.
So it was based on obviously Tom Cruise and Mission Impossible. I liked how it looked and I thought it would make for a great pattern interrupt. on a Facebook ad. And so to describe what a pattern interrupt is, imagine you're scrolling down your Facebook news feed and you continually every day see pretty much the same thing from the same people. And so a pattern interrupt is something that looks so different from the norm that everybody who sees it snaps out of their sort of hypnosis, their daily hypnosis of norm, and says, I like that. That is different. And even if they don't quite like it for what they could use it in their life for, it's at least admirable. And so I put that in the vault, and then I asked, hey, which one of you would like to have this same thing? And so in the vault, they all send me shots of themselves, headshots, half-body shots, full-body shots. And then with this, I did a few of these, so I'll show you a few of them I did here. And so some of them used them for Facebook ads. Some used them for Facebook cover photos even. Some used them just for posts on their normal Facebook page or Instagram. And so you can use them for whatever you want. But this is a way where you essentially get Fortune 500 style ads or Hollywood style ads on a serious budget, right? Instead of things costing, you know, like a ad campaign for a Fortune 500 companies, those are always in the millions of dollars. Always. I mean, the sort of, just the amount of people that they have on set is extraordinary. Where I have one person, I brainstorm, script, photograph or video, edit, and then upload, you know, all the things, just like I'm doing right now. So I wanted to do this as the vlog today because I'm working on a bunch of pieces for the vault, and I didn't have time to do both. And so a lot of times in this vlog, you're going to see my business and life are essentially the same. So you'll see me doing vlogs that are based on what I'm doing for my business, just so that way I can compress time. There's another piece I wanted to show you. So sometimes, remember when I was referring to, you know, sometimes I'll digitally alter my wardrobe? This is an example of that here, when I launched my Icon Engineering system.
Yesterday, I created my first branded piece for my Icon Engineering program, and I used that to stimulate conversation and to help attract people who would like to promote my upcoming program just after the new year. Well, I figured I would show how that image came about. I was watching the season finale of Homeland, and then I went online to read about things afterward, and there was this image of Claire Danes as Carrie in Homeland, and I loved it. So I thought, I'm just going to emulate that look. So what I did is open up Photoshop, I made a black background, then I took this grunge background, lowered the opacity and put it over the black. And then I needed these classified documents with redacted sentences that I could put in the background, just like it was in the Homeland promotional piece. Then on the other side, I needed, it was like a blank sheet of white paper I put in there, and then a more classified documents is what I needed on that side. And then I needed to take the photo of myself. So this needed to be a stern look, yet I like to do what I call the Mona Lisa technique, something I just made up because I'm fascinated with that painting, why it's so intriguing. And essentially, it seems to be because she has that little mischievous smirk. It's not much, it's just tiny. And so I like to do that. So I'll get in the frame of mind I need to be in for a spy. And that look works well for mystery. So I just elongate the neck, stare directly dead into the camera, and then give a little hint of a smirk. So something like this. So that's the look. All I did is cut that out, and then I color corrected a little bit, and then I made the eyes a little greenish, bluish, turquoise sort of look, because it would match the ultimate color scheme of the image. Then I put, I softened the skin also, and then I put more redacted sentences and classified documents over my face. But I needed a suit, and since I I do many branded images per week even. So if I had to buy all the clothes that I need for all the looks, it would cost me maybe a couple $100,000 a year. And currently, that's not within the budget. So I bought a $10 digital suit, fashioned it. I just tailored it around my body so it looks exactly as it would if I had the suit on. Maybe even better because I can tailor it a little easier than a tailor can with the physical suit. And then once I had the suit on, I just color corrected the entire thing to match the look that I wanted to go for. And it came out like what you see right now. So I took that image, used it to attract people who would want to promote for me.
So you see, I just fashion it around myself so that it looks like it would, if I went out and bought the suit, or if I took the time to get dressed. But sometimes it's cost prohibitive and time prohibitive, and so I'll sometimes just take a shot of a headshot and then put it into a suit and fashion it to look like me. And so that's another technique I use. I don't often use it with clients because they're kind of sketched out about it. But I'm so deep into the digital age and the digital branding that I don't care whether I buy a physical suit to then digitally photograph it, to then digitally alter it into an ad to put it on a digital platform. I just might as well skip the physical suit altogether, as far as I'm concerned. In real life, I obviously want to look good, but mostly I'm wearing track clothes all day, to be honest. So I hope that gives you a good idea of how I operate the vault. Again, this serves a sort of double duty to showcase my business, but also get this vlog out. Because today, first, I woke up with a bit of a cold, so I initially was going to do a thing on voices, because my voice is gravelly and deep today. So let's say, like, there's this. I already started the video, but I was gonna remark about this movie called
In a World.
Right, where they do this deep. They show you how to. They're voice artists for Hollywood, and so sometimes I like to play around with the voice. But anyway, that episode is coming this week sometime. But today I had to just get this stuff out because I was already working on it, and I hope you all are fine with that. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the week's vlogs as they come out, because I'm working on something really cool in the kitchen right now, and I'm excited. But I have to run to Walgreens to get some photos printed out, which I never do anymore. I almost didn't even know how to get photos printed, to be honest. But that'll be interesting, and I hope you'll like it when you see it. So, see you for now.